Hi friends, welcome to the Supreme Concept. Today we are going to focus on phrasal verbs related to power and authority. Earlier in the first lesson, I had told you that the best way to remember any kind of phrasal verb is to remember them using a sentence. But here in this particular lesson, I will teach you some most important phrasal verbs related to power and authority using a story, that is through John's political career. Okay, so let's begin. So the first phrasal verb that I have for you is stand for, which means to compete in an election. So for an example, John have decided to stand for parliament. That means John have decided to compete in an election for an official position like MP, you know, member of parliament. So stand for means to compete in an election for an official position. Then we have bring in, which means to bring or to introduce a new rule or a new law. Example, his party aims to bring in laws that would lessen the divisions between the rich and the poor. That means John's party aims to bring or introduce a new rule or a new law so that they could lessen the divisions between the rich and the poor. So to bring in means to introduce a new rule or a new law into a system. Then we have do away with, which means to abolish, remove or put an end to something. Example, the party believes that the monarchy should be done away with. Here the monarchy means one man rule. So John's party believes that the monarchy should be done away with. Monarchy should be eradicated, should be ended. So to do away with means to put an end to something wrong. Then we have clamp down on. So to clamp down on something means to limit or stop a particular activity, especially to limit an illegal activity. So for an example, the party is determined to clamp down on corruptions. Every politician is doing so, making such commitments before entering into their political career. So anyways, we just need to know what exactly clamp down on stands for, which means to stop or limit a particular activity. Then we have stand up for, which means to speak or act in support of a group or a community, etc. Which means, you know, to defend something you believe is important. Example, now John is going to stand up for the poor and fight for their rights. That means John is going to act in support of the poor. Okay, so to stand up for means to speak or act in support of a group or a community. Then we have go ahead. So to go ahead means to start to do something. Finally, John is elected and he is going ahead with his plans for the social science. That means John is elected and he has started doing his plans for the social science. So to go ahead means start to do something. Back somebody off, which means to support somebody. Back somebody. Your SB dot means somebody or someone. It's the shortcut form of somebody. Okay, so to back somebody off means to support somebody. Example, some of MPs from his party backed him off, backed John off. That means supported him. So to back somebody off means to support someone. Entered into. Entered into means officially agreed to do something. Later, he found that the party had entered into an agreement with the country's top business leaders. That means later John came to know that his party had entered into an agreement to do something wrong with the country's top business leaders. Okay, so entered into means officially agreed to do something, especially to do something wrong. Okay, in a wrong intention. Then we have carry out. So to carry out means to fulfill something. Now John confirmed not to carry out the wishes of big businessmen. That means John confirmed not to fulfill the wishes of big businessmen. So to carry out means to fulfill something. Then we have stand by or stick by. So stand by or stick by means to continue to support somebody. A few very good people stand by or stick by John and eventually decided to break away with them and form their new own party. No, own new party. So stand by or stick by means continue to support someone. And here, as you can see, break away means stop being a part of a group or a community, especially because you don't want to be controlled by them or you disagree with them. Okay, that was it for today's lesson, and I want you to pen down these phrasal verbs and to implement them in your daily life as well. And thanks for watching this video. Please hit the like button and share with your friends. And if you have any doubt regarding this lesson, please let me know in the comment section and I will definitely answer to your question.